Hey guys, it's EJ with Blockpad. Today we're going to look at dropdowns. So let's jump into it. So right here we have a lookup that looks at the data in this table. It looks up the letter and returns the word. So we want a dropdown that has the letters. The first thing we're going to do is insert a field. And then now let's make it a dropdown. So we'll click the field and go to properties. Scroll down to value definition. And on value definition, we want to click from option list. And so here we input a formula that ends in an array. The simplest way to do that, if you already have a table set up, is just to come click and drag the cells that have the information you want. And then we'll click OK. And now we've got a dropdown in our field. But in order to use this, we need to name it. So we're going to click it, go back to properties, change the name property to, we'll call it letter. And I like to show the name in a field, so I'm going to click show name, yes. So here we have letter equals B. We're going to come back to our original lookup formula and change that D, and we'll just click on the field and it'll put letter in there for us. So now when we change the dropdown, it goes to our lookup and it gives us the output we want. So a few formatting things. I find a lot of time these fields, they look better if you center them. Another option is to come over here to type and properties and change it to inline. And that's just going to make it the size of whatever it is. In this case, I'm going to keep it at cell. And I'm going to change the background color. We'll come back over to properties, change the background color to yellow, and put a border on it. Okay. So there we go. Now we've got our drop-down menu. We can pick whatever. A few notes I want to make, though, on the options list here. So this is a formula. And what you want it to do is result in an array that has the things you need. This one really easy way to do that is just to type the array in directly. So another way to do this would be to type in the text values directly. And in this case, we have the quotations because they're text values. So we've got the square brackets, the semicolons to separate it. And the quotations around the text values. We'll click OK. And that works just the same. One more example on having an array. What we have down here is a right triangle area calculation, very, very simple. And to change these fields, you just come in and type it in directly. Okay. But what if we want to make this a drop down? And we only want increments of 6 inches. So one way to do that would be to click it, go to value definition, go to option list, and we'll use the linear series function. So the linear series function will start at 6 inches. We're going to end at 5 feet. So our biggest option will be 5 feet. And then the step value will be 6 inches because we want increments of 6 inches. We'll click OK. And now when we come here, you can see our options range from 6 inches to 60 inches. And we can click whatever we need, whatever we want to do. So because that options list value is a formula that can result in an array, you've got a lot of options at your hands for how to create this drop-down list. You can, let your imagination run wild. But just to go back, the simplest way, if you have a table that you want to look up, let's go over to value options. The simplest way is just to drag and click the selection you want to do. Okay. And then that's it. All right, well, that's the video on dropdowns. Let us know if you have any questions or suggestions or what you want to see in the next video. Thank you.